students, welcome to electronics class. Today we are going to study RC oscillators. In RC oscillator, the first one is phase shift oscillator. But before going to study phase shift oscillator, we should know some concepts about phase or phase angle. So these are the concepts that we were supposed to study in first QC electronics. Because the syllabus has been reduced, we couldn't go through that. So now we'll just go through these concepts so that it will help you to understand the phase shift oscillator well. Okay. And in first QC electronics, we have already studied the passive electronic components. You people already know what is resistor, what is capacitor, and what is inductor. So inductor is not required because we have already finished the oscillators using inductors and capacitors. Now we are going to study RC oscillators. The oscillators which uses R, resistor R, and the capacitor C in the feedback circuit. Those are called as RC oscillators. So in RC oscillators, we need to study how this R and C will respond for the AC quantities. Whenever you have already studied resistor, so how the resistor is going to respond for a whenever AC is applied, and how this capacitor is going to respond for a AC voltage or current. Okay, that no need to write all these things because this is a first year concepts. Only you need to understand this. What is phase? Phase is a time relationship between the two alternating quantities. That is, the fraction of time or angle elapsed since an AC quantity just passed from a reference, given reference point. For example, if this is the, I'll show it here. If this is the reference point, this is one of the AC quantity A, and one more AC quantity that will start from here. So this AC quantity that is called as B, that is first we got A is already being passed. After some time, if I take this as a time axis, after time, some time has been elapsed, there is another quantity that is B. So this is the phase difference between these two AC quantities, A and B. So this, see, for example, it will start from zero. Whenever the A has been started, B was no more in the picture. When B has started, A has already reached its maximum and coming down. So this AC quantity is leading this. That means the AC quantity A is leading the AC quantity B. So this is a phase difference. So what is the phase difference? The time relationship or the angle difference between the two AC quantities. So why it is required to analyze any of the AC signals, we require this phase or phasor diagram. What do you mean by phasor diagram? Phasor diagram is a vector which is having both magnitude and direction. For example, this is a phasor diagram where the length of this line indicates the magnitude. And the direction, the arrow mark indicates the direction. So in this is a reference axis we have taken, that is a zero line. And if the AC quantity is moving in the anti-clockwise direction, then that is taken as a positive phase angle. If the AC quantity is moving in the clockwise direction, then that is taken as a negative phase angle. So in this thing, the reference, this B, AC quantity B, is lagging behind the reference point, whereas AC quantity A is leading the reference point. Okay, so what will be the angle? Angle of leading. This is AC quantity B is lagging by the angle phi. Lagging by the angle phi, whereas AC quantity A is leading by the angle theta. Okay, so that means it has been started much more earlier than this. Okay, if I take this as a voltage and this as a current, voltage has been developed, then current start flowing, something like that. Once the voltage reaches to its maximum value, then current starts from zero point. Like that, you can tell. So phasor diagram, which is A and B. So okay, in this some AC quantities I have shown you. See, for example, here OA and OB are the two AC quantities. A and B are the two AC quantities. Where OA in magnitude, the length of the OA is greater than length of OB. That means the magnitude of A is greater than magnitude of B, and the direction is same here. The direction is same, and no phase angle will be 0 degree. No phase difference between these two AC quantities. So if I represent in the waveform form, that will be like this. Both have started at the same point and reaches its maximum at the same point, and again coming back to minimum at the same point. So these two AC quantities here, they don't have any phase difference. So 0 degree phase difference they have, you can tell. Okay, or 360 degree phase difference, what we are talking about in oscillators. So these two having 0 degree phase difference. So whenever we are analyzing the phase analysis into AC quantities, those AC quantities must be of same shape of the waveform. That means sinusoidal waveform only we are going to. Those two AC quantities should be sinusoidal form only. One is in square and one is in sine. We cannot analyze those quantities. Okay, their shape should be same and their frequency should be same. Their magnitude may vary, that doesn't matter. Only the frequency and the shape should be same. Then only we can analyze two AC quantities at a time. Okay. And here in this case, A is in this direction and B is in opposite direction. So these two AC quantities here, they are having a phase difference of 180 degree. They are having a phase difference of 180 degree. And in this case, A is leading B by 90 degree. This is B. This is A. Okay, here B is leading A by 90 degree. Okay, because B has been started earlier than A. There's a little confusion in the color. This should be B. Sorry. This is A and this is B. Okay. B is leading A by 90 degree. So this is what about phasor diagram. Now you people know what is phase shift. How to find out phase shift? We consider voltage and current, you'll get a better idea. in our CE amplifier circuit or in our upper amp inverting amplifier circuit, the output voltage, if you are measuring both input and output voltage in the same CRO screen, CRO we have studied in first PUC, what happens in that output voltage, input voltage you are measuring in the same screen, what happens? Their output is 180 degree out of phase by the input, right? So now we'll study AC applied to pure resistor. Whenever a AC is applied to pure resistor circuit, what happens? The current I is going to flow through this. Vi is equal to capital Vm sin omega t. What about II? Small v, I will tell. I is equal to Im sin omega t, where Im is can be represented as V by R. So whenever you apply AC to the pure resistor, the voltage and current, the voltage and current will be in same phase. If it is voltage, voltage and current will be in same phase. That is, there is no phase difference between the voltage and current. That means Ohm's law, resistor behaves same for AC and DC. Okay, resistor behaves same for AC and when you apply DC for the resistor, then also it is Ohm's law will be applicable. Whenever AC is applied, then also Ohm's law. For example, there is a for particular voltage, the current, the proportional current will you will get. Okay, you can calculate resistance at any point of voltage and current. Okay, you'll get a different value of resistor. So resistance behaves same for AC and DC, and also whenever you apply AC for the resistor, the current and voltage signals will be in phase. So now whenever AC applied to pure capacitor, AC applied to pure capacitor, what happens? Here, whenever AC applied to pure capacitor, AC voltage Vm sin omega t, when you apply to pure capacitor, here the current leads the voltage by 90 degree. So, how? You might have this derivation in second PUC physics. For example, there is a formula Q is equal to Cv. I will represent in small letters. Q is equal to Cv, where V is equal to what? Vm sin omega t, right? So what is the formula for current? Current is equal to Tq by dt. So if you differentiate this with respect to time, what you will get? C and Vm will be common, d by dt of the constants sin omega t. So I is equal to C into Vm d by dt, differentiate sin omega t with respect to t, cos omega t into omega. So I can be represented as omega c vm cos omega t, and omega c is equal to what? 1 by xc, or xc can be represented as 1 by 2 pi fc, right? 2 pi f in the sense omega, so omega c can be represented as 1 by xc. So vm by xc into sin omega t can be written as, sorry, cos omega t can be written as sin omega t plus pi by 2. So where I is equal to, this can be written as Im sin omega t plus pi by 2. So here current expression can be sin omega t plus pi by 2. So how you will represent the voltage and current here? This is the small v, the current leads the voltage by 90 degree. That means in capacitor, whenever the pure AC supply is applied to the pure capacitor, current is leading the voltage by 90 degree. So if I take the current in this axis and voltage, so voltage is lagging behind the current by 90 degree. Either current leads the voltage by 90 degree or voltage lags behind the current by 90 degree. So this is what happens in case of capacitor when you apply AC. So now we have got to know, when AC is applied to resistor, both voltage and currents will be in same phase, right? When AC is applied to capacitor, current leads the voltage by 90 degree. So if you know this much, understanding the phase shift oscillator will be very easy. Okay. Now we have studied when AC is applied to purely resistor, what will be the voltage and current in phasor diagram? Both will be in same phase, right? When AC is applied to pure capacitor, voltage lags behind the current. That means current leads the voltage by 90 degree. That we have studied. Now I combine both resistor and capacitor here. The RC circuit which is going to used in the feedback network of the phase shift oscillator. So when R and C are connected in series across the AC voltage source VI, so what happens? When an AC voltage applied to the RC network, phasor will be, current will be same for the series network. So I will take the current in the same axis. As of now, I forget the current. Current and voltage for the resistor, I will be in same phase. But what about the voltage across the capacitor? That is lagging behind the current. The same current is flowing, that I consider I. The voltage across the capacitor is lagging behind the current by 90 degree. Right? So, where is this VI then? So this VI will be, we know that voltage, this voltage divides among these two series components, right? So voltage, usually if two resistors are connected in series, V1 plus V2 according to KVL, here it is vector sum of voltage across capacitor and voltage across resistor. So Vi will be taken here. If this magnitude, if I consider here, tan phi is equal to xc by r. Okay, it will be vc by vr. Vc can be written as I into xc. Vr can be written as I into r. I gets cancelled, so it can be written as tan phi, this angle, xc by r. So when r is equal to 0, v naught leads vi by 90 degree. Okay, when r is equal to 0, v naught leads vi by 90 degree. And if r is equal to infinity, phi will become 0. Right? When r is equal to infinity, all the input voltage drops here. When r is equal to 0, there is no this line. Whatever the voltage that will drop across capacitor and the input goes here, the output current. So output leads the input by 90 degree. When r is equal to infinity, when infinite resistance finds, then all the voltage drops across that, right? So the input voltage becomes the Vr. That times this phi angle, phi will become 0. So the value of R should be set in such a way that it should provide the phase shift of 60 degrees. See, it is impractical to have R infinite and also 0 degree. So we have some finite value of resistance and we have some finite value of capacitance over here. So the RC network together with the AC source provides the phase shift of greater than 0 degree, less than 90 degree. So this RC network output voltage will be providing the phase shift of greater than 0 degree and less than 90. That means it is going to produce the output which is the phase of the output will be less than 90 degree. So R value will be set in such a way that this RC network is going to produce the 60 degree phase shift. Then if I insert two RC sections, 60 degree phase shift from this RC section and the potential at here that again divides among these two, right, which is this potential at here will be 60 degree out of phase by this input voltage, right? The potential at this point is going to divide among these two components. The potential at here, whatever the voltage at here, that is 60 degree out of phase by the input. That volt, again this RC network produces 60 degree phase shift. Here the potential at here is 60 degree out of phase by this, 120 degree out of phase by this. And if I connect one more RC circuit, the potential here is 60 degree out of phase by this voltage, 120 degree out of phase by this voltage and 180 degree out of phase by the input voltage. So when we consider three RC sections in the feedback network, we are going to get 180 degree out of phase signal at the output. This is the principle of phase shift oscillators, RC network phase analysis. Principle of phase shift in RC circuit of the phase shift oscillator. I guess we will stop here, because if I want to explain the phase shift oscillator, then again it is going to up to 40 to 50 minutes. So continue the next session, the phase shift oscillator. Just understand these concepts well, then very easy to understand the phase shift oscillator circuit. Okay, thank you.